Batch schedule overrides and absences. For any individual child, you can set an override or absence by going to the Schedule Overrides and Absence button for that specific child and choose either an override, which is a different in and out time for a particular day, or an absence that might be part of a day or the whole day that they're scheduled. So a partial absence is what we use today as our example. It's going to be a field trip, and I'm also going to do an override for our school agers to show an in-service day. I want to show you a report before I actually make those overrides to show you the current schedule. And the current schedule is going to be the classroom schedule analysis report right here. This is a graphical report. I'm going to do my field trip for the kindergarten room, and then I'm going to do the in-service for our school age room. So I'm going to run those two. I want to set my date range to be this week and save settings. That will allow me to not have to set the date every time we run the report. And so our kindergartners are basically scheduled all day, 9 to 3:30 for most of them. And the school agers are scheduled essentially just in the afternoon, 2 to 5. And so that's how it is every day of the week for each group. You can see that Wednesday and Thursday, just like that. Okay, so let's go out and make our batch overrides and absences. Before we go to the batch overrides and absences screen, I'd like to set a filter. So I'm working with first just my school agers, and then the second batch will be just the kindergartners. So I'm going to go into the filter button and use my child criteria, say that I want my classroom to be just the school agers. Exit. And now I'm working with just my school-age children. That makes it easier for me to work with on the screen. When I go into the family data function, batch schedule overrides and absences. Now, the only children I have here are my school-agers. So this is going to be for tomorrow, the 25th, a Thursday. It's going to be an all-day in-service day, basically to 5:30. Classroom is going to be the same room, school age, and the comment will be, oh, we'll say in service. And then I would apply this to all if I want to apply the same in and out time to all children. If I need to modify specific children, maybe someone's picking them up a little bit earlier or something, I could modify individual in and out times. But I'm going to leave them just like that so you can see this in the report. I'm going to save that, and then I'm going to exit and reset my filter now to work just with the kindergartners. I don't need the school agers. I just need the kindergartners so that I can do an absence for them for the field trip from 1 to 3 in the afternoon. Once again, go back to Functions, Family Data, Batch Schedule Overrides and Absences, and this time I'm going to choose Absence. And when we choose absence, we get a reason over here rather than a classroom, because we're actually kind of punching a hole, if you will, in their schedule. This will be from 1 p.m. until 3 p.m. tomorrow. And it's going to be for a field trip. We don't have that in our list, so I'll just use other. And I'll just say zoo trip here. Apply to all. And once again, if I needed to modify the in and out times for individual children, I can do that right there. I'm just going to leave it 1 to 3 for everybody. Click save. And now we've applied those items to those children. Now if I look at Wendy, for example, she's a kindergartner, and I go to her schedule overrides and absences, in her absence screen, we'll see that 1 to 3 absence right there. It would also show on her review button when we look at her review. So we've got essentially a hole punched in her schedule. She's there from 8 to 1, then out from 1 to 3, back from 3 to 4:30. We'll see that on the report as well. Let's go back to the classroom schedule report and use classroom schedule analysis. And once again, we've got kindergarten and school age selected. I want to run that for this week. Now I want to go forward to with Thursday. And you'll see in Thursday, the kindergarten room has a hole punched for everybody in that room between 1 and 3. That's for the field trip. And you'll also see that the school agers, who are normally scheduled just in the afternoon, they're scheduled all day for that in-service day. So that's how to apply batch overrides or absences to a group of children in Procare and how they carry through on the schedule reports.